Hi there, guys. My name's Nicky.
Hi, everyone. I'm Perry.
And welcome back to... Welcome back.
We just had a short break.
Hi there, guys. I'm Nicky.
Hi, everyone. I'm Perry.
And welcome to our YouTube channel, The Divine Truth Experience. So, as you guys may have known, if you have been subscribed to our channel previously, is that we haven't been actually recording videos and publishing them onto YouTube. And that's because of a number of reasons. The first being that both myself and Perry have been dealing with a lot of our own personal emotions that we've really had to deal with, which we'll talk about in this video, actually. And then also secondary to that is that I basically decided to upgrade all of our camera recording and also video editing equipment and technology, so that hopefully the actual video is a lot better quality for you guys, and also it would be a lot better for us when it comes around to the actual editing of the videos and the footage itself. So hopefully you guys will be able to see the benefit of that. And now I'll just pass over to Perry, and he'll explain what we're going to be talking about today.
So today's topic is going to be all about spirit influence, and specifically negative spirit influence. So the reason why we want to talk about this is because Nicky and I have just had an experience a few weeks ago where we started to receive quite heavy negative spirit influence. So it's quite fresh in our hearts on how to explain it, and the feelings are still there. So so basically, just wanted to take this opportunity to share our experience with you guys. Basically, it's just so that if you ever have this experience, that you may be able to watch this video and find it of some use. So what we'll do is we'll explain kind of how we came aware that we were under influence, and then we'll explain what we did whilst we were under the influence, as an example, like how did we get out of it, and then at the end we'll describe to you how life is after the influence, and hopefully by taking you through that little journey, you may just pick up some tips, or you know, there may be some experiences that we did that you can benefit from, basically.
Yeah. So I think the first thing, just for the benefit of people who have not come across the teaching of Divine Truth before, mm-hmm. is to just quickly describe what a spirit is.
Yes, very important. So basically, what a spirit is: a spirit is a human being who has lived on Earth before. So just like Nicky and I now, you know, we're having our experiences on Earth. A spirit is a person who has just died, basically. And when we use the term spirit, what we're talking about is a person who's in the spirit world. So they were a human, they had a life on Earth, they died. But basically what we're saying is they haven't died, they've passed over and are now living in another realm that we call the spirit world. So spirit influence is all about being influenced by one of these spirits, basically. So the clue is in the name there. So this is what happened to Nicky and I. So basically, we'll start now to Nicky will explain about kind of like how we were influenced by spirits.
Yeah. So I just settled the scene for you guys, so you've got a bit of a context about the story and, you know, all the events that happened for us. So first things first is I feel the best thing to do is just share with you guys both myself and Perry's aspirations for the future and what we actually both want to do with our lives. So we both know now in our hearts what we want to do, and that is to continue growing in love towards God, become more of a loving person, and also being able to assist any other people on Earth or spirits in the spirit world who also want to grow in love towards God. And that's completely based on their desire. And also another huge desire for both of us is to just assist in the spreading of divine truth on Earth. So that's kind of where, you know, our aspirations are currently. And I know they will be like that for the rest of our times on Earth, but yeah, so just to give a bit more of an overview, myself and Perry, we both live in London. 8 or 9 million people live in London, and we recently we we're having these feelings of potentially maybe moving abroad, so out of London, out of England, and moving to an island called Lanzarote, which is, for you guys who are not sure where this is, it's an island, it's a Spanish island, and it's located in the Atlantic Ocean, but it's really close to Africa, really. So that's where we were going to be moving to. And the reasons why we felt that that may have been a good idea at the time is because we both have quite a lot of injuries to do with money. So we both got quite a lot of fears about money and, how we're going to be able to support ourselves through what we're doing and through a donation method, essentially. So we felt that we should basically move from London to a place that's cheaper. So that's why essentially we chose to go to Lanzarote. So that's kind of that part of the story.
Yeah. So what happened next was basically we were unaware of being influenced by spirits. So the question was how did we become aware of that we were influenced by spirits? So basically what happened was Mary Magdalene, Jesus and Mary, if any of you guys have been watching Divine Truths, sent us an email outlining basically what was going on around us in regards to spirit influence. So I won't go into the whole email, but basically we're saying, you guys are being influenced by kind of murderous spirits, really dark evil spirits, and what they want to do is basically take Nicky and I away from locations where there can be where we can kind of share divine truth to lots of people, and basically what she also said was that if they could have Nicky and I dead, then they'd like to just basically have us dead as well. So
they literally want us dead.
Yeah, so they kind of want to stop us from sharing divine truth, wipe us off the face of the earth, and that's it basically. And they'd have no qualms in doing that. So maybe if you can imagine receiving an email like that, what kind of state you might find yourselves in. So
yeah, I think one good thing is just to quickly explain why spirits may want to do that, and that's because basically when you pass from Earth and you enter the spirit world and you're interacting with your environment in your spirit body, you're the exact same person you were just before you died. Essentially, you still got all the same emotions in you. You know, there's no instant, kind of knowledge where you know everything. It's literally like a complete continuation of your life. It's just that now you've shed your physical body from your soul. So so generally you get two types of spirits, really. You get spirits that are in a very kind of dark condition where they've got a lot of evil and unloving emotions within their soul, and they are choosing not to process through these actual feelings and are instead choosing to engage in their emotional addictions. And they generally do this through influencing people on Earth, mm-hmm. who are still on Earth in their physical bodies, and influencing them to basically take certain actions on Earth so that these spirits can then also share in that energy, and also basically for the spirits, they receive all of their emotional addictions, so they then feel good about themselves.
Yeah, and then like Nick said, you've also got the good spirits who are there to assist us in our development in love, take care of us, guide us, point us in the right direction. They want to show us what our passions are and our desires. So we have, what's called a spirit guide and a spirit and a guardian as well. So they're kind of generally the two types of spirits that exist. Obviously through the email, Mary was very concerned with these dark spirits. So Nicky, do you want to maybe explain how a dark spirit can manipulate us? How is that even possible?
Yeah, so the way it kind of starts is whereby you're engaging based on an unhealed emotion within yourself, so an emotion in yourself that is unloving. If you're choosing to basically engage in your own addictions on Earth, or not feeling through your fears and wanting to avoid your fears, that spirits in a dark condition, they can influence you in that specific area to take certain actions because you don't want to come face to face with your fears, for example.
So that would be like...
So like for us in this situation.
Yeah.
Both myself and Perry, we've got a lot of fear to do with like angry and aggressive men, like older men in particular. And that is because both of us had quite a similar upbringing in our childhoods. Both of our fathers were quite, well, mine especially, but they were very verbally and also physically abusive to us. And so we've grown up, you know, from our childhood experiences, fearing like an angry man, but, you know, because we're fearing of what, you know, how they may make us feel based on how we felt when we were younger, you see.
Yeah, so Nicky and I, you know, we're not fighters. So, like, in our adult life, you know, if we're in an environment where there's, like, a lot of angry men, like, Nicky and I tend to, like we'll get, like, a bit afraid. Like, we're not one of those guys who's then going to think, oh, there's a fight going to happen. Mm. Wicked, like...
Let's get involved
and, like, let's attack. It's like, no, like, you know, Nicky and I, like, we're just kind of, like, we're scared of those feelings that bring up a lot of fear. So...
And we want to avoid that situation, really, don't we?
And we want to avoid it. So if you can imagine, like, a violent person would easily be able to influence us with the threat of violence compared to someone who is not afraid of violence. So, like, if, for example, if Nicky wasn't scared of me, I couldn't make him do stuff he didn't want to do because he would just be like, no way, I'm not going to do that. Whereas at the moment, maybe some of the injuries that Nicky and I have, I could just, you know, project some threats towards Nicky and I could maybe make him do anything I wanted, basically.
Yeah.
So the same goes, as I was saying,
spirits.
With the spirits. So they're just a person who lived on Earth, who've got the same tendencies. So if they're an angry, violent person on Earth, then they can be that in the spirit world.
They will be that in the spirit world, don't they?
And they can still want to project and control and manipulate. And
yeah.
That's the position, basically, Nicky and I found us in with this group of spirits, basically don't want to have the teaching of divine truth on the planet. They have, like, actively
for
would prefer...
centuries.
Yeah.
For centuries, these spirits have chosen to basically, you know, try and destroy any of God's truth on the planet because the spirits themselves, they don't want to feel their own fears from their own earth life, what's happened in their childhoods probably. And instead, they are choosing to engage in unloving behavior. And, you know, they want to damage people on Earth, you see. And with regards to that, like, the spirits that were influencing both myself and Perry, they've got these big addictions to wanting power and superiority over people. You know, they're wanting to have, like, adoration from people. They're wanting to... as I said, they're wanting to scare people, they're wanting to get sexual power and dominance over people as well. So, you know, they're quite in a pretty dark condition, really.
Yeah, and Jesus told us that like he actually knows these spirits, and they've been doing this for a long time. I don't know if it's hundreds or thousands of years, but they're very good at what they do. So they can really influence us, you know, if you don't know how to handle it, basically. So so with all this, like, information in mind, maybe we'll explain...
our initial feelings when we read that email.
Yeah, and then what we'll do is we'll guide you through what we did when we read the email, what actions we took, and then kind of what's happened afterwards, basically. So we'll take you through the whole process of feeling that we had these negative spirits around us, what we did to get them off our backs, and how you can continue to live your lives without having this negative effects of these spirits. So should we start out?
I guess with that email.
With the email.
Yeah,
so we got the email, and then we actually... so we read the email. And like Nicky was saying, like, we had plans to go live off in this island. But fortunately, what we'd done is we'd just booked for 2 weeks first just to see if we would like it.
Just to check it out.
Yeah, so that was a godsend because obviously receiving this new information, we didn't want to live there anymore. So we almost packed up our whole life in London and moved all across to this island. So what we decided to do was, like, okay, I was like, Nicky, like, we've booked these flights and we've got this villa booked for 2 weeks. why don't we just go there and take this 2 weeks time just to pray and work our way through all the emotions that Mary had suggested, and then hopefully we'll come out the other end and we'll be healed from those negative influences, basically. So that's what we did, didn't we? We still went and booked the flights. Well, we had the flights booked already. We took the flight, we got to Lanzarote, and we stayed in our villa. And basically, we created an action plan, and we'll share with you now what that action plan was to kind of heal these emotional injuries for us. So do you want to outline what the action plan was, Nicky?
Yeah, I mean, like, one of the important things just to mention is that, like, when we received that email, both of us, we instantly then began to feel the actual nature of the spirits around us, because beforehand we were feeling that it was our guides, like, helping us and helping us see the different potentials around us and what we could do.
Mm-hmm.
So we were kind of under the impression that our guides were kind of guiding us to move to Lanzarote, basically. And we're both in a place now where we act on stuff. We don't not act now. So that brings its positives, but also its negatives, if you're not sure where your influence and your guidance is coming from, what source. So yeah, I mean, as soon as we received that email from Mary, I instantly went into fear. I instantly felt the nature of the spirits around us. I felt that the spirits were now, as they knew they were then exposed from that email, I could just feel them projecting, like, all this, that they were just laughing. They were just constantly laughing at us. They were projecting a lot of rage towards us. They were threatening us. And I just said to Perry, I was like, mate, I've got to go into my room. And I went into my room and I was there. I was literally, you know, just shaking. And, you know, I was actually feeling that, you know, these spirits, that they're going to influence somebody on the street to basically, you know, physically harm me in some way, in whatever way they can influence that person, if that person is open to that influence. And I was just feeling that, you know, it's just hopeless. Like, you know, I can't escape from this situation.
Yeah. And I was getting feelings of doubts and threats. And you can kind of feel when it's like a spirit, because the thoughts feel like they're dropped into your mind. You're like, oh, where did that thought come from? I've never really thought that before. So I was getting doubts about wanting to spread the truths of God and all this type of stuff. So I was kind of almost ready to give up my whole progression and just kind of like walk away from it all. So you can see the power of these threats, what they can start to have an influence upon you. So I think it's really important that Nicky said that. But like the positive part of acting, as well as like, we chose to act in a positive way.
Not ignore the email which Mary and Jesus sent, because I know a lot of people, when they receive feedback from Jesus and Mary, a lot of the times, unfortunately, they get even more spirit influenced and they then start projecting anger at Jesus and Mary. And, you know, like that one thing that's sticking in my mind is like, you know, like we're in this real, really hard situation right now. And I was just saying to myself, I'm not going to let myself go down that route. I'm not going to let myself be lost, basically. And when I went into my room, I was processing through some fear. I was going through feelings of feeling like I've lost my soul, like feelings that I've lost God, almost, in a way, like lost my guide. And I was just feeling all this hopelessness and, you know, just feeling that that's it. I can't get myself out of this situation. And one thing that stuck in my mind the whole way was that when I was feeling those feelings, that I remember Jesus saying in one of his YouTube videos that God will never ever bring you a situation in your life that you cannot handle at that moment in time. And I was just holding on to that feeling and that belief that, you know, both myself and Perry can get through this situation that we've attracted. And by the way, we definitely attracted it because it was our own will. We were choosing to basically not deal with our fears predominantly, and we're choosing to avoid our fears. And that's when all these spirits could then come in and could influence us and manipulate our wills into doing something that they wanted us to do. So, and bearing in mind our aspirations that I spoke about earlier on in this video of wanting to share divine truth with as many people as possible, we were going from London, a city of 8 or 9 million people, to a tiny island in the middle of nowhere, really, with barely anyone on there. And, you know, because we were not so sensitive to the actual feelings coming from these spirits and the nature of the spirits themselves, we would just went along with it. We didn't really feel through it properly. We didn't even logically look at the situation, mm-hmm. bearing in mind what we wanted in our long-term goals, what we wanted to achieve. And, yeah, we were kind of just like going along with it. And so that's really where it, how it all started and how it all came about, essentially.
Yeah. So then what we did, once we decided that, you know, we said, okay, Nicky, let's just go away for these 2 weeks. Just for a couple of days, what we did was like, we watched all the material that Jesus and Mary have presented regarding spirit influence. And we watched quite a lot of stuff about connecting back with God and stuff like that. And also looking at the seminars to do with addictions. So if after this, you know, watching this this talk, I definitely recommend watching all those for yourselves as well, just to kind of like recap and back up, obviously with a lot more material from Jesus and Mary. So what we did was we took all that advice on board. We took the advice from Mary, from the email. We watched a lot of footage of the seminars just to re-educate ourselves on how to heal these injuries within us. And yeah, we set out to Lanzarote just to dedicate this time to our own soul progression. And basically that's what we did for a whole 2 weeks. So what we're gonna do now is we're gonna explain to you what we did in those 2 weeks and share with you our experiences. So if you have these same experiences, you know, this might just give you some tips and some guidance on how you yourselves can maybe get through negative spirit influence, and hopefully you'll come out the other end. So
yeah, so yeah. What happened was, as Perry mentioned, we flew over, we decided to fly out there, and we were feeling that, you know, the place is quiet. It would probably be better for, you know, it would give us more time, you know, we won't feel like rushed into things, we'll be out there in the nature, you know, it's completely opposite to London. You know, London, massive city, a lot of busyness and whatnot. And then we go into a place, you know, in an island in the middle of nowhere, where it's just a lot of nature, it's very quiet. And we're just like, you know, this is a good opportunity now. We can actually use this. We can use it. We can engage our wills in actually wanting to deal with these, you know, emotions within us that we've been avoiding for a while.
Yeah.
So, and by the way, like when we got on that plane, you know how, you know, you're usually extremely excited getting on a plane, going away abroad. I cannot tell you how unexcited we were when we sat on that plane and we were just talking to each other and just like, whoa, like, mate, like, if we don't deal with this stuff while we're away, I don't know what is going to happen with us. Like, we don't even know what's going to happen or how bad it is going to get. So, yes, pretty much we got there and we basically decided that we have to do certain actions every day,
yeah.
And focus our hearts every day on various things. So like the first thing we did...
Well, yeah. No, I was just going to say like there was some physical things that we did first.
Yeah.
I don't know if you were going to say
that.
So we took care of our physical environment. So what we did, we drank a lot of water. You know, Jesus recommended this quite a bit. So we were drinking like 4, 5, 6 liters of water a day, just because that helps you connect to your emotions. So first, we prepped our bodies and we just ate very lightly. We just had like some fresh fruits in the morning and then we'd only maybe eat heavier in the evening. So first thing when we woke up, downed like a liter of water, even 2 liters. Mm. And that just helped flush everything through and then connect to our... We were able then to connect to our emotions and our bodies. So
yeah, what we did is in the morning, you know, we saw each other, had a bit of a chat, and then we both went our separate ways for the rest of the day. And we were both on our own, maybe, you know, between 6 and 8 hours a day whilst we were there, you know, solely focusing on our own feelings, our own injuries within us, and actually wanting to deal with them. So what we always did every day, we kind of went off on a walk, and we were quite lucky in the sense that there were a lot of mountains around where we were, and they were within quite a short distance from where we were staying. So we just went into the mountains, away from all of the people really, where it was just ourselves, our guide and God. And, you know, we just got ourselves in a place where we could actually just 100% focus on what we had to focus on, with no distractions, basically.
Yeah. And there were some key points of what we took on board from our research, of going over some of Mary's blogs and, you know, listening to how she herself has gotten through spirit influence. And I think there was like 5 or 6 main kind of points that we probably want to share with you of what we did. And I know what Jesus and Mary have done and shared before of like how to get through this. So maybe we'll like bullet point those, and then we can talk a little bit about our own experiences doing that. Okay. So I think probably the first and the most important thing, which a lot of people forget, is number one is to pray. Like
so important.
I can't tell you how important that is. Like you might think to yourself, you know, how am I gonna, you know, I can get through this on my own. However, the imminent danger Nicky and I were feeling about being wanting to be wiped off the earth, I can tell you the first thing that we did was just we wanted to pray. Like we were just, you know,
we were wanting help so badly. Like
it was hands and knees stuff.
It was desperate. It was actually desperate.
Yeah,
like it really was. You know, because we felt the darkness and the danger we were both in, and you know we were like, you know, we have to deal with this. If we don't deal with this in this 2-week period, you know, something major could happen with us, and you know, that's it. So
yeah, and kind of like one of the feelings I had was just like, I don't know how to deal with this. Like I've never come across this before. I don't know how to do it, and that was scary. And then I was like, oh, but I can pray to God. And then once I had that kind of feeling, oh, I can pray to God, that allowed all the other stuff to happen. So
yeah, and I've been attacked by spirits a lot of times before, but this was just something on a complete different level based on the spirits that were actually having that influence over us and their condition. You know, so a lot of times spirit influence in itself can last a while. It depends on, you know, how much you're willing to deal with the emotions and feel the grief of getting attacked by these spirits. But yeah, like based on the whole situation, you know, it was just real desperation essentially. And our feelings of self-reliance, that was ironically one of the things that the spirits were manipulating in both of us. And the spirits are essentially, they're trying to segregate both of us from sources of love and truth. So
yeah,
they're trying to separate us from God, our spirit guides, our other spirit friends, and also Jesus and Mary themselves. And we were quite shut down to actually receiving help from,
yeah,
or even asking for help from Jesus and Mary. So,
which is actually one of the points in one of the 5 or 6 major points to do is to familiarize yourself with like the teachings of divine truth and God. So you could read like the Paget messages, you could read through them. I read quite a lot of Through the Mists, so I could understand the spirit world, so I've got less fear around, you know, what happens when we die. You could watch some of the Divine Truth Teaching seminars. You could, any kind of material that relates you and connects you back to God and the source of love, like do that and like inspire yourself to want to pray. So I definitely say that's on the bullet points of list. And then the next thing to do is what Nicky was talking about earlier, was like feel the feeling. So like the first feeling which came up for us was fear. So we prayed, and then we felt the emotion of fear of what we were going through. And then that led us to like different emotions coming up. And one of the ways we did that was through writing. So what we would do is we'd get like really specific of what the fear was, so we could like feel that. And we realized the more specific you are of what your fear is, like that emotion will come up. So, you know, that's kind of like you being truthful, basically. So the truth will set you free. when you get specific of what it is, the emotion that you have, that's when stuff will start to move. I don't know if you want to add anything to that.
Yeah, one important thing as well was that we both were essentially, like when we were journaling, we were actually writing really slowly, just so that as we're writing, we could then like connect with our emotions a lot better. And one thing I always did when we were away, and I've continued doing it since, was basically in my journal, starting it off with writing "Dear God," and setting my intention that I'm now writing to God, and I want to like receive God's assistance in what I'm going through, basically. So whilst I was writing, it was almost like a prayer as well. And both of us found that when we did that, and we were specific with how we were actually feeling, we were being truthful with how we were feeling at that specific moment in time, we just realized how much easier it actually was to connect to the emotions themselves, and to then receive assistance from God and also our spirit guides.
Mm-hmm.
Like one amazing experience I'll always remember is that when we got there, I was feeling like almost so hopeless, and just like, you know, there's no way out of this. But as soon as both our wills were engaged in wanting to ask God for assistance, wanting to deal with the actual emotions themselves, I cannot tell you like how quickly I then felt my guide was back with me and God was there again. Because when the dark spirits were around us, although God was still there, I felt so far away from God. I just felt like, you know, complete bleakness really on the situation. And I could feel my guide wasn't there. I could feel my guide couldn't help me because I was choosing beforehand to not deal with these issues that I knew I had, but I kind of like got the cigar out in a way, and I was kind of like saying, oh, you know, I've made some decent progress, and, you know, I was feeling happy about myself and whatnot. And without actually realizing that if you like take your foot off the gas, even briefly, that, you know, dark spirits can like basically just jump all over you essentially in that space, and they can lead you down a complete wrong path. So,
yeah, so
doing all the writing.
Doing the writing with the emotions. Obviously, we had heads up from Mary that some of this stuff was related to our fathers, like father issues and emotional injuries regarding that. So I was very focused, and I know Nicky was like, we started to talk to God about that first. That was like the topic. So for example, like I would write like, "Dear God, you know, can you please show me my injuries with my father? Or can you, I don't understand, God, what's happening with me. Can you please help me?" And I just keep writing and writing. And at some point, what would happen would be, I'd start to write a certain word, and it would bring up an emotion of grief within me. And then what would happen, like, all these memories of when that particular thing happened started to like show up in my mind, and that would just trigger my emotions even more, and I would just then drop the pen and I'd just be sobbing, because all the feelings and the grief coming from my childhood, 3 years old, 4 years old, 5 years old, 6 years old, all started to flash in front of me in my mind, and then I was just in it, and I was just like in the snowball of emotion. And you can feel God's presence, you can feel your guide, you can feel the grief leaving your soul, essentially. And it actually kind of feels a bit of a happy space at the same time. It's like, oh my God, these feelings have been in me for so long, and now they're finally coming out. It's like, it feels like such a godsend. And then each experience of doing that over and over, like your faith would start to increase. So you want to pray more. So the next day we'd set out with more desire and like more vigor to want to go and to get through.
To keep going.
Yeah, to keep going.
Yeah, yeah. Like it was a big thing. Like we're spending, as we mentioned, we're spending, you know, 6 to 8 hours a day on our own, dealing with, you know, like reflecting, getting us into, you know, asking God for help, and wanting to actually tackle all of these things head on that we've been avoiding for such a long time. And like one thing that I've learned is just how important it is to use our will, like in a direction to love. Like our will is just so important. Like depending on which way you go, depends on the type of spirit influence you end up attracting as a result.
Mm-hmm.
So, like, when, you know, you're actively choosing not to deal with an addiction you have or a fear, then, you know, you're choosing not to love in that situation. And in that situation, a lot of dark spirits can then come in because they will then sense, they'll be attracted to you, and they'll sense that they can get their addictions met through influencing you in a negative way. If that's an addiction, it'll be because you're wanting to receive something yourself. Whereas if they're manipulating the fear, it's basically you not wanting to come to terms with the fear you have and wanting to avoid that as well. So that's where they can influence you. And essentially what you do when you're in a space of wanting to avoid, you know, feeling your fears, is that you give power to the spirits. It's like you actually hand them over your power. And from there, they the spirits can then basically get you to do whatever they want you to do, because they don't have your best interests at heart. They don't have our best interests at heart. You know, they just want to either cause pain in your own life by getting you to take certain actions you wouldn't normally do, or they want to influence you in a way so that they can then receive their addictions and their pleasure through you. So that's always something really important to remember.
Yeah, what Nicky said there is super important about how you use your will. And in fact, one of the biggest lessons that Nicky and I learned in that two-week experience was actually to actively use our will on a daily basis to want to pray, to want to feel our emotions. And that basically is an example of using our will in a loving way. And what happened once we started to activate our will in that way was we, as Jesus explains, we started to feel our emotions and we were starting to heal. So now what we do is, now that we're back, we've taken that same model and, like, we're just more desirous in our prayer. Like, we just want to pray more because we've seen the results of what happens when you engage your will to want to pray, and to want to heal and to feel the love. Kind of like you think to yourself, like, why wasn't I doing this before? And it kind of is like, it's so, like, we realize how dangerous it is to not want to pray and how dangerous it is to not want to heal these emotions. Because basically what's going to happen is you're going to be acting from these places of fear, like, all your life until you deal with the emotion that's driving it. And then once you start to experience, once you've gone through that and experienced what your life is like with love, basing decisions on love and acting from love rather than fear, and then you see the result, you just can't, like, believe how different your life is and how much different you feel. And it feels so wonderful. It gives you the faith to want to carry on and pray as well. So kind of what I experienced, and I know I'm pretty sure Nicky did as well, is like our desire to want to pray, like, increased. And I know that there's a lot of the assistance group seminars presented by Jesus and Mary where they talk about that. So I would highly recommend watching those seminars again, of, like, wanting to increase your desire, or wanting to increase your faith and your will. And when you put those into action, you'll start to see the results, but you won't see those results or feel those results until you've taken that step. So prayer is, we've talked about prayer before, it's super, super, super crucial. And Jesus also presented a seminar called, What is Your Treasure? That was it. And basically talking about, like, how much time you allocate to prayer and your own soul progression. So obviously what Nicky and I did, we specifically took a 2-week period and daily for 6, 7, 8 hours a day, engaged our will,
dedicated ourselves
to prayer and to healing our souls. So obviously you can see, if you only use 1 hour a week or 5 minutes a day, it's not going to be as powerful as engaging 5, 6, 7 hours a day. So what I would really, really, really recommend is to like look at your lives and seeing where you're avoiding taking the time to spend time on yourself and spend time in prayer and spend time on your soul. Nicky used to have a very demanding job, and you know his desire for his own soul, for the battle of his own soul, you know, he quit his job completely.
Some people
have like the fear. They go like, "Oh, but what about my job? And what about this? And what about that?" Well, Nicky had that same fear, man, and he quit.
I've still got my fear about like money and stuff. Yeah. But I realised at the time when I went to quit my job, I was just realising that it's not what I want to do. It's not my passion. I'm just engaged in that job, you know, 5 days a week, 8 hours a day. Just there to satisfy or to avoid my fear of not having the money. And, you know, I quit my job, created the site, the forum, met up with Perry, now live together, creating all these projects. But it's now, you know, it's a case of, you know, just accurately measuring your life and just looking, you know, really truthfully about, you know, where you're at. Because you can't progress if you're deluding yourself as to where you currently are. And like one really important thing to remember is that, and one that we both experienced while we were away for those 2 weeks, is that as soon as our wills were engaged in wanting to deal with our like addictions and fears with regards to this situation, these dark spirits, like how instantly God, like we felt God was back. We felt our guides were back helping us. God was always there, but because of the amount of the dark influence around us, we felt that God was miles away. We just felt so far away from God and our guide and, you know, just feeling all this hopelessness. It's great. Like, it almost shows how great God is in the sense that we hadn't yet, you know, fully dealt with the emotions that caused us to be manipulated and influenced by these dark spirits. But as soon as we just used our will to want to deal with them, we felt protected straight away. Like, we felt that we could actually go through the emotions, and I could feel my guide was helping me so much with my writing and helping me, like, you know, realize these things I've been avoiding. And one thing really important is that, like, in the months before leading up to this situation, I knew for a fact in my heart that I was avoiding things. Like, deep down, I knew, I'm like, oh, I've got this issue, I've got this issue, I've got that issue. And I just didn't want to deal with it. You know, I was just, as I said, I was quite happy with where I felt I was. And as soon as my foot was taken off the gas, it was like, boom. Like, the dark spirits came in and manipulated our wills because we didn't want to deal with stuff. So it's the chances are, if you're feeling like, oh yeah, no, I've got this issue, but I don't want to deal with it yet, the chances are you're probably being spirit influenced in a negative direction by a group of spirits around you who also want to avoid their own stuff, or they want to basically make your life worse, essentially, you know, one or two things. And, you know, it's quite a sad thing for us, because we didn't even realize at the time, like, which spirits were with us. We weren't sensitive to feeling the condition of these dark spirits. We just felt it was our guides that want, you know, that were helping us see that there was all these other potentialities, and we just went along with that because, you know, we didn't want to deal with our own stuff, and, you know, we got into a lot of problems.
Yeah, so if kind of like you're sat at home and you're watching and you're thinking to yourself, like, I used to be a little, I have a tendency of like delaying things. But what this process showed me was like, don't delay in your own soul progression. Like, it's super, super important. And the longer you delay and avoid your emotions, it's just going to get worse and worse and worse and worse, to the point where, you know, you can end up like in a position like Nicky and I were. So, you know, invest in yourself and take the time to want to deal with emotions, because if not, It's just things are just going to get worse. And if you don't deal with them now on Earth, you're going to have to deal with them in the spirit world. And I don't know what it's like there fully, because I don't remember being there in my sleep state. But I've got a feeling that my intuition tells me, you know, if what I don't deal with now is going to really bite me in the future. And I just heard like a really important thing by Jesus on a seminar the other day, when he was saying, your actions today will actually create your future. So, well, like when I remembered like the importance of that, it's like, man, everything that I do day to day, minute by minute, second by second, it's going to affect me in the future. And you know, I'm tired of having negative outcomes. So I'm just like, man, now is the time to start dealing with this stuff. Now is the time. And as soon as my mind, because it still does, I'll be honest, think, no, I'll do it later. I remind myself that it's just going to get worse later, so I might as well just do it. I might as well just do it now. And I hope, and I do hope, and I do pray to God daily to have the will and desire to want to deal with things straight away rather than delaying it. And you know, I might slip. I'm not to say that I'm perfect, but that experience, like I'm just saying, I just really want to share and emphasize the importance of like taking the time out to work on your own. Your soul progression, really.
Yeah, and trust me, like if you do find yourself in a position that myself and Perry were in, and feel the darkness and the bleakness of the situation, and you end up going through it and getting out the other end, trust me, you're going to want to continue praying to God and wanting to deal with things before it gets that bad. Like, honestly, it's almost a case of, you know, we've heard Jesus saying a lot of times about how out of hand spirit influence can get if you go along with it and you want to keep avoiding things. And, you know, it's just like until you felt the danger and the darkness that you were in, you don't realize the gift of what Jesus was saying, as what he has been saying in all of these seminars. You don't want to get yourself in that position. And also by us now, like reflecting and remembering back to how we were and where we were at in that point in time, we're just like, yeah, there's absolutely no way, you know, we're going to let it get that bad again, because it was just a nightmare. It was honestly just a nightmare. And yeah, just so thankful that we received that email from Jesus and Mary, you know, like for them expressing their concerns to us, mm-hmm. and for giving us that gift, in even, you know, making us aware of the situation, even though we weren't open to asking them for their assistance. That is just such a huge thing, and I'll always be grateful for. It was literally another life-changing moment for both of us.
Yeah. It was totally like, I mean, Nicky just said the word, the gift, and what I felt this in the past as well, but I felt it again and again over that period we just talked about, is like the feeling of gifts from God. And you know, it's not like, you know, you're gonna get, you know, the big paycheck or the new car or all this, that and the other. It's gonna like just like pieces of information or feedback or whatever it is, like your law of attraction, once you like you want to see it, like they're God's gifts. And once you're seeing your life like that, you just start to appreciate the gift of life in general. I'm not like that all the time. Like, I'm not saying, you know, I'm like on cloud nine
every day
thinking my life's a gift, because sometimes I still don't feel like it is. But you start to appreciate more, and then once you've got appreciation, you do feel more alive and life does feel more enjoyable. So engage the process. I encourage you to engage the process, and you'll start to feel these gifts and being sown into your life. And it won't be like, oh, poor me.
Oh, I've got to deal with this, got to deal with that.
Yeah.
You get more into a place where you're like, no, I want to deal with this. I want to deal with this. I want to go through this emotion. I want to go through that emotion. I want to tackle this. I want to tackle that. Because it's like previously we've felt the benefits of doing that, but also the key is now we've also had the experience of not dealing with emotions and realizing where we can end up quite quickly based on the negative spirit influence that comes in if we're in a place where we do want to avoid our stuff, essentially. So, you know, now we've had both, it's like, you know, help spur us on even further in just wanting to keep on going with the process and just realizing it is a process. Like, these are all huge lessons that we're all going to have to learn at some point if we want to grow in love. And also one thing I've realized is, if you're someone who likes to blame spirits, like the dark spirits around you, or, you know, that spirit influenced me to do this and I did that, you know, it's the spirit's fault, just stop with that. Like, honestly, like, you're getting worse because you're being unloving now to the spirit as well. Even though they're in a dark condition, you're being unloving back to them, but also you're just in complete denial of the whole situation and how bad it could get. Like for me and Perry, it probably got as bad as it could ever get because of our aspirations, what we are wanting to do with our lives, that these dark spirits saw us as like a real threat, and we ended up attracting, you know, probably the darkest spirits anyone could attract, essentially because of them wanting to stop us being ourselves and stopping us from doing what we wanted to do. So, you know, like, I haven't blamed these spirits at all. I'm just like, look, no, they're here because they've been attracted to us because we've chosen previously to use our will to avoid things. You know, it's not their fault. I mean, it is their fault in the sense that they're choosing to perpetrate all of these unloving things to us. But, you know, like, if we continued blaming these spirits for months and months, we're just playing into their hands, and also we're getting further away from God, we're getting further away from Jesus and Mary, further away from any other sources of love and truth. Our guys won't be able to connect with our guys well at all in that sense. And, you know, before you know it, you're in a completely different place to where you were before. And also, it's almost a case of, like, the more you learn these lessons of will, the more you realise that, like, if you're choosing to avoid your feelings, God and your guide and your guardian and also any other loving spirits you have with you, they literally cannot, they will not help you. You know, they're not going to come and say, oh, actually, you should know better and help you that way. They won't do that because we've all got free will. And, you know, they respect the gift of free will that God's given to all of us. And, you know, we were actively using our will to avoid things, so they couldn't help us. They had to just let us be and then just see, you know, let us come to terms with what we've attracted. And then once we then chose to deal with it, that's when all the help instantly came.
Yeah, just as Nicky was speaking there, just like the words of personal responsibility was just going around in my head. And it hit home, that period of how major taking personal responsibility for your own life and your own emotions, that this path is. And if you're one of those people who doesn't want to take personal responsibility, it will be tough. I was probably I'm still to a certain degrees in that bracket, but I felt now the danger of what happens when you don't take personal responsibility of wanting to feel emotions and wanting, you know, you yourself. It's like God, what God wants to do is God wants to teach you on how you can do this for yourself with God. And what I've realized is by going through that experience, like, it feels good that you've actually gone through it yourself. Like, you learn about yourself and you learn about God and you learn about your relationship with God. And for me, this is what it's all about. If it's not about, you know, discovering yourself and discovering God, you know, then there's not going to be much joy in that. And I found great joy, even though sometimes it's painful, in the discovery processes of finding out about what my weaknesses are. And God does it in a beautiful way. And there's not much more I can say on that subject, really.
Yeah, and trust me, like, the more you go through the dark stuff, the dark emotions, and if you get yourself into quite a bad situation that we've got ourselves in, like, honestly, when, you know, you become a lot more humble, you know, you want to ask God for assistance all the time. You know, you see any gift from any other person as an actual gift. You know, you don't see it as something you've come to expect over time. You know, it's like you fully, or it's almost like you really understand the nature of the assistance you're getting, like, not just from, you know, Jesus and Mary, because they, you know, Jesus and Mary are extremely busy all the time. We're just so lucky that, you know, they want to offer us with their assistance, and it means so much, that does. Also, you know, our guide, you know, another person is constantly there with us, wanting to help us, wanting us to grow as well, and they want our personal, they want us to enjoy our lives as well. So it's a case of, like, it's like you get to a point where you can see more, like you get into a higher viewpoint where you can just see more and you understand a lot more about the whole situation and how everything works in that regard. Like, I'm not saying, you know, we know loads all of a sudden, but we know more than what we did before about will and how important it is, and you know, just how things can change either way depending on how you use your will.
Yeah, I mean, just to kind of finish off really and just like recap what Nicky was saying there, it's just like things can go either way, like, so quickly, like your joy can, you know, increase quickly if you engage your will that way, or you can go down, you know, the slippery road really, really quickly. Mm-hmm. And it's just up to us, really. It's up to yourselves to decide what it is you want to do. So I hope that this video clip was of value for you.
I'm sure it will. I'm sure it will. It's based on the condition of the earth and, you know, how it is at the moment, with a lot of people wanting to avoid their pain, their sadness, and, you know, seeking addictions. A lot of these negative spirits, you know, will have an influence on a lot of people, and have been on earth like for like hundreds of years, and they still do now. And you know, it's just a case of, you know, just getting to a point where you can help others as well when you, you know, learn these lessons yourself.
Yeah, you kind of naturally want to start helping others. I think, I mean,
yeah.
I know that's a passion of Nicky and ours, but I think generally what happens is when you start to receive some of God's love and favour, kind of like you want to start, you know, helping.
Sharing that.
Sharing what you've received. So this is our way of sharing. And yeah, we plan to do more. We'll also put some links on on this site to some of the information that we use to help us get us through the spirit influence. So you have the benefit of reading that as well. And anything else, Nick, that you can think of?
I think that's it tonight.
Yeah,
bro.
Cool. Well, thanks for listening. And we hope to make more videos soon. And we'll see you next time.
Cheers.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Hi there, guys. Nick here. Just wanted to add a quick bit onto the end of the video, just to explain that we lost the focus 2/3 of the way through the actual video itself because our battery that we were using initially actually died on us. So the video basically cut out from that point on. And obviously once we realised that and realised we lost the last third, we were pretty good. So what we did was we put in our spare battery and tried to carry on the discussion from the point where the battery initially cut off. So hopefully we've managed to cover over all the stuff we covered in the video initially, and hopefully the main thing is, as long as you guys can hear clearly what we're saying, that's more important than like seeing us anyway. So hopefully that'll be okay for you guys. And also the more we get to learn about the equipment and whatnot, the better the whole experience should be. So yeah, thanks for that anyway, guys, and see you again soon.